melting. Hi everybody, welcome to my behind the scenes for my new video, Wide Awake, in which I'm a lot more gothic than army. We're doing a video with this French director named Tony T, who's done a lot of really cool videos for people like Skrillex, and he doesn't speak much English, and I don't speak much French. Tony's made a few music videos, but I don't think he's ever actually made a video with the artist in the video. So it's kind of a first. One of the biggest challenges of this shoot is that this video is going to be in 3D.
The traditional cutting for a music video is very short, quick transitions from one shot to another. So one of the things we do for quick cutting is to make sure that those objects that are not at the same depth can hand off from one shot to the next. In this case, we use a process we call depth balancing. In other words, we're moving things through space all the time to guide your eyes smoothly from one object to the next. Because we are creating an illusion by giving the left eye a separate image from the right, and that's the purpose of glasses in 3D, is to isolate which eye sees which picture. We are hoping to make an event here that when people put the glasses on, it will stop them in their tracks.
We might be on the forefront of something new. We probably might just f*** this video up, though.
Katy?
Here we go.
So we're here in the labyrinth. It's the beginning of the day. This is basically our setup shot. I've entered the labyrinth of my life, I guess you would say. And there will be different symbolic moments that occur as I walk through the Valley of the Shadow of Death. It's very beautiful, it's an amazing set, it's very detailed. There's a lot to take in, and it's very dark. I always like to bring something different for each visual, and I had an idea to do a video like this, just to kind of do a retrospective of my last year through artistic moments. And, you know, the tour and finding myself and coming out okay on the other side. Last time I was looking a little bit more masculine in part of me, and this time it's a lot more feminine, but it's kind of got a dark The Craft vibe, which I love that movie. I was never allowed to watch it growing up, of course not. I think my parents will be horrified at this video.
Very unusual, very different.
Risky, little edgy.
Well, I wrote Wide Awake for the movie, pardon me, but I wrote this song for the film. I actually had the idea for what I wanted to say, and I brought it to my co-writers, Max Martin and Dr. Luke and Bonnie McKee. And we were in a studio for 2 days and just hashed it out, basically. But I thought it would be cool to make the music video 3D because the film is in 3D.
You just yell it out!
Yeah, the walls! Walls out! And look up to the forces. So sweet till it won't pop. Here I am.
Nice to meet you. Zoe, who is the little girl in the music video, she's kind of like my innocence. She's past me.
Sometimes I grab my sister and hold her down.
I think we're gonna be best friends. She may be kind of symbolic of the innocence I've lost along the way. And she's trying to lead me back to a better place and lead me out of the labyrinth.
I am a really good singer. Last Friday night, do it all again. I really like that one.
Zoe, this is kind of an Alice in Wonderland set where all these pieces of the floor they're gonna start falling away.
Yeah, but pretend.
Yeah.
Are we scared away. A bit?
Yeah, you're a little bit afraid. Katy, put your hand up against the mirror. You feel the energy.
I think one of the high points of this is where Katy is standing in a hallway of mirrors and has a realization and comes forward and she's reaching into the mirror. Well, that means that we bring her actually in front of the screen and then her hand comes further in front of herself. So that moment is probably the most dramatic moment of 3D in the piece. Now, Katy, when she reaches out, we are the mirror. She reaches right out into the room and she feels the glass and the glass explodes. And when it explodes, that's where the magic of 3D comes in. When you can actually get an audience to forget that they're watching an optical illusion, be caught up in the story, and then see something that is so compelling they can't believe their eyes. And that's where you hear the wow.
You have to have that kind of like, oh no, like you're scared of, like there's a huge dog and it's about to come and attack you or bite you.
We shot the floor practically with Katy standing there. And similar to how we build the maze, we take a bunch of reference photographs of the floor itself. And then what we do is we recreate the floor, the surface in 3D in the computer, and actually start cutting it like you would almost like in real life, except you're doing it digitally. And you pre-cut the floors. From there, you just take that and animate it using real physical based properties. You have gravity, you have drag, and you set up basically a plane that goes through and decides what pieces you want to crack when. And then it gets kicked into gravity and kicked into drag, and the smoke starts reacting according to how something of this mass would go through it. And it's all computed and then rendered out and then composited to look real.
All right, guys, it's day number one and we've just wrapped for the day. I've made it through half of the labyrinth with my younger version of myself. So it's kind of like this weird like Fight Club thing. But it's been a really long day. There's some symbolism on my dress. There's a lot of butterflies. Probably because I will evolve from a moth to a butterfly at some point in this music video. There's a lot of symbolism. You gotta just kind of catch it. We're trying to put a lot of subliminal things in there too. Welcome to day two. I am channeling Ziggy Stardust now. And a little bit of like a glam 90s grunge. This scene symbolizes the darker moments in the labyrinth of my year last year that I never spoke about publicly. I never really had a child push me into the hospital though. Oh my gosh, you're gonna make them fly?
They have jetpacks.
No way. Hey, what's happening,
here,
really?
3, 2, 1, action!
Oh my boy!
We have two minotaurs that are like big, menacing orderlies with bull heads.
I'm so huge, it's crazy.
Obviously trying to impact Katy's life in a way that she doesn't want them to. So what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna ratchet them out as if the little girl blows them out of the scene.
Boom!
Now I am a fairy nymph. Okay, Zoe, what are we gonna go and do right now?
We're gonna go meet the unicorn.
Unicorn!
Woo! Wow! Hi!
He's a petty.
What's his name?
Aspen.
Hi. Oh, yeah.
Oh!
He's gonna lick me!
He's a real unicorn?
Yeah, but his horn only comes out every once in a while. It's like
very magical when you see it.
Bye.
We're losing our 8-year-old girl, but we've got one more shot to do with her.
Action.
Breaks through the heart. And then they leave and they go back to Kate's childhood home location.
And separate, separate, pull her out.
Oh. Fail.
Perfect, cutting.
Zoe is the coolest kid I've ever met. She actually brought kittens to the set today so that we could just hang out with kittens.
Here comes the sweetie pie of the world.
What's its name?
Mademoiselle.
Mademoiselle. That was a great day today. Yeah. I'll see you tomorrow. Same time, same place? Same outfit?